Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to Keep Productive YouTube channel. If you're brand new, but if you're a regular, welcome back. So today's video, guys, we're taking a look again at Notion. Notion is one of the biggest trenders in the productivity app space at the moment, and for very good reason. It is a resource that is making waves in terms of its functionality and sort of canvas-like experience, allowing you to plot out whatever style of productivity that you want. It's very smart, and it's a good introduction to this sort of productivity app. And what we'll be doing today is we'll basically be getting a lot of questions about this, is guiding you through your sort of first day on Notion. And the reason why I want to do this is because people, I feel, are struggling a lot when it comes to, okay, I've downloaded Notion, I've got it in front of me, how do I even begin with this? Because it's such a, it's not a complicated application, it's really up to you, and that's what sometimes the scary thing is. Let's say you're like, okay, I want to try it for a full month alongside Trello and see what happens. Or like you want to bring everything over like I did from Trello to Notion to some extent. It's a scary experience because you don't know actually what you want to do. So hopefully this video will give you a nice overview. This video will be timestamped, guys, so you can go in the description below and skip forward even this introduction and find the section that you want and an area that you're struggling with. And this actually was really relevant because I was going to film this one last week, but I didn't get around to it. And then Sandra tweeted this morning. Sandra is at Medieval, and she tweeted, I downloaded Notion, but I'm finding it difficult to navigate. It's about collaboration. It feels a bit of a Wild West. Not sure about collaboration either, because I can't see what my co-editor created in there for me. Help. Seems like a cool platform, but it's not intuitive. I agree with some of our points here. I agree that when you land on this application, it makes it very difficult, not the onboarding, it just makes it difficult to choose what you want to do with it. So hopefully this overview will show you how to set up your Notion in terms of like a brand new account. I will be releasing a Skillshare class in the next month. I've just been a little sort of backlogged. We'll get around to it. It'll sort of take you through Notion completely, but this will give you almost your first day with it and a few of the recommendations that I would put your way. So hopefully this is a nice overview. Let me know in the comments what you think and feel free to use the timestamps below to skip forward. Anyway, guys, let's jump onto Notion. Okie dokie, here is a brand new Notion account. And this is something that I was playing around with the other day for the actual Skillshare feature, but I wanted to go over it because I think it's quite an important experience, and especially when you're getting started. So before we get started, I want to show you my own Notion account. Obviously, I'll be doing a full separate feature on this one, so don't get freaking out. Don't be like, Francesco, stop showing me this really intricate setup. This is what my setup looks like, and this has really taken almost a year now to really get to where I want to be. Obviously, I'll be doing a full review and sort of overviewing my sort of practice towards that, but that's a sort of end goal to some extent. It's taken me a fair while to do, and I haven't really rushed it because I didn't really want to, and I haven't really focused too much of my time on getting that perfect. I've more made it as accessible as I can. So guys, as you get started with your Notion account, obviously you'll go through the whole like download process and onboarding, and most of the time you'll get a few recommendations to use a templates function. This is great. I think the template function here, and obviously all of the new area, the database area, and the default empty and import pages are quite fantastic because you get a good starting point. But I do think you first have to sit down with yourself. My recommendation is to grab a bit of A4 paper, could be A3 if you wanted to. And this is something that I did when I was replotting my Notion, or even just giving myself my, I think I did it on the first couple of weeks of getting Notion. I sat down with this one, and what I did is I made sure I had a nice half an hour bit of spare time. I sat down with it and I went, okay, how do I really make Notion a dashboard that I want to enter, and how do I make best use of it? So with that A4 bit of paper, I started jotting up what most, like I needed to access most as I got started with my Notion account. So I think when I got started, I put on the weekly area that I wanted. So an area that I want an agenda for the week, like the week ahead. I put on my 3-month roadmap, which I work best on. And that was previously on the likes of Trello. I put on a few of my personal branding things. So I started to add in a fair few things that I thought would be helpful and something that Notion allows me to create. And what I did there is once I created and designed this area, I essentially like got my laptop, put the piece of paper next to it, and basically tried to replicate what I got from a first sketch. And that process only took me about 10 minutes in total. And it was of an evening. I remember just sitting down with like a cup of tea, and just having like headphones in, and I don't think Becca was home for like half an hour extra, so I had the time to really focus, and I basically plotted out exactly what was on that piece of paper. From here, you know, you land on that homepage and you sort of can panic because you're like, okay, what does that look like? So I'm just going to show you what that can look like in terms of an example. So let's say I had that piece of paper in front of me. I would really start with a default page, because a default page is essentially your workspace. I would call it your workspace. What I would do to start off with is set yourself a nice gallery picture. And I believe when I started, I had one of these space ones, but there are a host here and you can also upload your own, but I really wouldn't worry too much on that factor. So I'm going to choose the space background and I'm going to keep this space emoji. I recommend having like a really quirky emoji there, and then title it something like, Nina's workspace. Something clear, something nice that you can enter that feels personal. And that's, I think, really an important process. So the next thing I did was, I believe I made a subheader here. And the reason I did this is because, very similar to what setup I've got now, and something I modify a lot, is almost a mini description of what this workspace is about. So I put like, I think I put like, home to, or I put in this case, Nina's work. Or something like this, something that represents the workspace. I mean, it could be absolutely anything for you. Then what I did is I put a divider in. This is another part of the blocking process, just so it separates it from the sort of dashboard area. Now, the next thing that I did is obviously I mentioned that I brought in a few pages. So the best thing to do is title the different areas. And I think I had long-term focus stuff here. Bear with me a moment. I actually put a header here. Long term, and I believe I put another header next to it, so I'm going to put short term, and obviously you can manipulate this to however you like, and then I put a divider below both of these, which you can copy and paste here, very easy to do, and then you can use the slider to determine which section you are going to use the most, and in most cases I would expect you using the short term if you're using things like notes and agendas. So this is where the templating comes in, guys. I think templating is quite an important process inside of Notion. I wouldn't worry about their default template. So the thing I would do is create a page. So let's say this is your 3-month roadmap. Now, all I would do is go over to the romance section, roadmap section here, and click use template. Now, they recently updated it. If you're someone that doesn't necessarily like a board layout, a calendar layout, or even a table layout that they've recently introduced with Notion. And I'm not someone that does want this, but that's a interactive layer of it. So what I tend to do is when I'm starting out is just, I'm just gonna clear. I'm not sure how to actually delete it. So since last time they actually did this, they modified the templates to be a bit more fixed. So anything with a table or anything like that can get quite confusing. So my recommendation, if you want to make a roadmap that is specific to certain items, you can use the weekly agenda. And what I was mentioning before is you really don't necessarily, if you see a template that maps to what you want, then you can clear everything. So here I'm going to turn this one into a roadmap. So here you are. Really simply, I have created my own roadmap. And of course, you can use all of the different sections here and using bullet points, etc. But this is just really an example of how you can create your own sections pretty rapidly. And as you can see here, I have a direct link to the 3-month roadmap. And let's say I wanted to just shuffle this across a little. I can do so like that. So I think it's really important to start with templates, although sometimes they might be a bit too fixed, and then modify from there, and modify all of the elements around it from cover to emoji and everything in between. But I think that is a really, really good starting point. And my recommendation is to fill all of this space here quite rapidly. And one thing that you can do is, of course, you can use pages, and you can add blog posts and information like that just by doing this. So for example, if I wanted to start a blog post, I could easily do that and kick things off there. But as you can see, it will appear here. So my recommendation is to keep clear namings to things. So for example, let's say blog for client A, maybe even do Tuesday. And you can have a link to it there. Or let's say you want to be even more organized in a case, you could even make yourself a dead simple homepage. So let's say I wanted to make a, all my blogs. Ooh. And you could do links, link to page, to an existing page. It does not like it. Here we go. So all you have to do is drag that in. And as you can see, it appears inside of there. So if I wanted all my blogs there, you can have your own blog page there. And it's really easy to do with the different sections. And this is something that I did on my personal account. As you can see here, I've got a list of all my current projects. And I can even use the actual checklist function to actually create my own area here. And I've used some articles below to make it a little bit more efficient. So over time, I've sort of gained and controlled areas. But of course, you can use the, let's say you wanted a dashboard with a calendar. Of course, you can use the brand new inline calendar function. And always check for that inline to create your own calendar. And you can make it as big and as wide as you like. So for example, if you wanted it just for this section, then you can. Obviously, that would make it really super thin. But if you wanted it for the top so that you roll into your different sections here, then of course you can do so. And that is all interactive and something that you can modify and play around with. So as you can imagine, Notion is a space that you can manipulate yourself. You can design your own layout, but it's important to note to keep it simple as you get started. My recommendation is to create the bare skeleton of your Notion account with the core areas that you work with. I remember when I got started, I pretty much kept it to the 3-month roadmap, the weekly focus, and the client overview. And I didn't have all of this sort of stuff in between. So it's something that you can continually modify, continually develop, and something that will take time to improve and improve on. So guys, I really hoped that you enjoyed this feature. Let me know in the comments how it helped you or whether it didn't. whatever you find fit to put in the comments. But it was really good going over this. I think this is a continual struggle with people, especially as we're introduced to a pretty brand new technology, the canvas of a productivity app. Anyway, guys, hopefully that was a nice overview. Let me know in the comments what you think, and I'll see you guys in a future. Make sure, if you're not subscribed as well, to hit the subscription button. It'd be great to have you here in this community. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Make sure you have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.